In this tutorial, we are going to cover if you have a raw data in place, right, and you need to analyze that particular data, okay, with the help of pivot table in MS Excel.
All right, so this is the basic data sets, guys, and I'm going to demonstrate you how we are quickly, you know, make this particular data set into the present table form, right? So this is the data sheet. Basically, you can see total 501 count is there, right? And then I've just created this into the table. Okay, now no need to create into the table now. So okay, this is a variable name, mine. Okay, let me show you how I quickly created. This is my table name. Okay, if you are not aware how to create table, you can watch my earlier series, guys. You will get to know that, you know, how to create a table into the Excel, right? But by pressing the Control D. Now clicking on the create pivot table. Correct. I'm just dragging and dropping this particular fields as per our requirement. Okay. In pivot table fields, there is an option called setting, right, guys? You can view the values, rows, and columns as well as the filters as per your convenience. So here I've clicked on this option. Now this. Okay. As per your convenience, how you want to see it. Okay. I preferably choose this thing, so I'll use this. Double click on there. Okay, it'll automatically get adjusted. Now click on the any field how you want to present it, right? I've just added the expiry date over here into the rows, so it will automatically get bifurcated into the months, right? You can see. Okay, you can change that. Okay, I'll show it to you how to do that. Okay, I'll just add the earthquake data is here. Yes, no. Dates are added. You can see month expiry and then dates, whatever dates would be there. Correct. So just add a drag and drop your fields as per your convenience, guys. Once again, okay, once you add the values in it, or maybe costing in it, whatever policies cost is there, right? Just add that. And now convert, we need to have one sign in place, right? Dollar or maybe rupees sign. You can do that in MS Excel. It's very easy. Okay, so I'm just reviewing the field, which field I do have available right now, right? So accordingly, I'll see, this is the four fields I can see, region one. So I can accordingly play with the fields and make that data more presentable view, right? I'm just adding those into the filters. So accordingly, when I click on the filters, it automatically show me the that particular region value in it, correct? So this is the Jan month ka data, and then I'll select this, click on the rupee section. You can change as per your country's accounting. I'm just making out the changes into the decimal pointers, and then okay, I'm good. And then this is the value, basically dragging and drop. Let me add few more fields in it, and so for the analysis purpose, we can have the analysis tab open. Okay, and then design, you can, with the help of design, you can change the designing for this particular table. And now you can see the layout, right? Layout, you can see it's a very useful function, guys. Okay, again, the outline view, you can see the data has been outlined like this in a tabular form. And I click on this particular thing, dates has been added under the top, correct? Cool. So and now if you want to group and ungroup it, you can do it directly. Now you can have just click on the ungroup section. You can see the, I can only see the dates over here, right? But by pressing on the group, you can also bifurcate this particular data context into the quarters, months, years as per your requirement, right? So I'm just click on the years, quarters, and then okay, I'm good. So now you can see in one view, one snapshot view, you can see the, you know, data simply has been visible for us, right? So complete upon us how we want to present this particular data, right? So data could be in any form you might get from in a CSV file, you know, or maybe whatever TXT file. You need to just import it into the Excel and post that. You can see with the help of PO table, you can easily create a data sets like this, right? And then again, you know, to play with the layout function, guys, most of the time, right? Now I don't want that particular grand total, so I've just removed the grand total on and off option, right? And then this is the thing. If this particular quarter month is not fall under your particular company's standard, so you can add one more column stating that so and so quarter is there, and accordingly you can drag and drop. If you need that particular video from my end, just comment in the below section, I'll do that as well. Okay, I've just removed the quarter over here, and now you can see the year and month. That's it. Okay, and that's it. Yeah, so this is the Jan month data, complete upon you. If you want to display again the flood details and the whatever details you want to add it, you can just drag it, drop across into the columns, and yes, it's invisible for you guys. Okay, so again, I'm just pressing onto the same room, and then cool, I'm done over here. Cool, and the complete upon you guys how you want to represent it, this particular data. You can, you know, with the help of Alt F one key, right, you can directly create this particular table into the, you know, chart as well, correct? So in insert there is an option called chart. You can directly go there, or if you don't want to go there, you can directly click on the control Alt F1. Okay, Alt F1 is the key which will help you to directly insert the chart. Okay, so I'm just adding the, you can add the multiple columns as well, right? As rightly, I'm just playing with the data to, you know, visualize you how we can demonstrate these things, correct? Complete upon us. Again, I'm there is an analyze button. When you click on the this particular PO table, analyze tab or button will be open on the top right, analyze design, and that things, correct? I'm just dragging and drop. So the fields which we are going to use it, and you know, removing and unremoving whatever fields we are going to do it, right, as per those particular fields which we are seeing it into the charts as well, guys, you know. So make sure that, you know, you are adding the appropriate fields which we need to visualize it, correct? So I clicked on the recommended chart now. Okay, and then as per your convince, you can just add it. Okay, so this is the chart. Basically you can press the shortcut key once again. I'm just reiterating Alt F1. Okay, with the help of those key you can, you know, directly insert the chart, correct? Again, it's an Excel recommended chart when you press this particular chart, correct? So this is the pie chart, basically basic information about the PO table, right, guys? You can again change your requirement, correct? I just want the you know, this particular axis, you can do it. Okay, ultimately it will automatically change into the PO table as well as simultaneously into the change in the chart too, correct? So it's complete upon you how you want to play this particular data, correct? So I'm just removing this particular thing, and then as per my understanding, I'm just keeping this ahead. And this data is basically guys, you know, this is my demonstration purpose. So yes, if you need this particular file, you can comment on YouTube channel, okay, and I'll give it to you across. So let me show you once again. Okay, I just press the shortcut key. Now you can see the small chart is come up. Okay, data label, turn on the data label. You can see the data labels on which particular month having a data sets in place, correct? So this is the thing, and you can again play with the charts as well. These are the design, basically you can change the design as per your convenience. There are more designs, see, you can change it, and then switch rows and column. You can see that, right? The labeling is there, right? This particular state wise, so state and the quarters you can change automatically. And this labeling, if you need in the bottom side, you can directly click on the right click, format legend, bottom legends will automatically get the bottom side, okay? And then switch row, you can see we can play with the data again. Change chart type, you can anytime you can change your chart. If you don't like it, you know, if you want to make data more visible, you can do it complete upon you. Just click on the change chart type and then you can automatically get change this particular thing. Right click, hide all, so automatically whatever fields are there you can hide it. And then there are grid lines are there in the background, you can remove those or maybe hide those, that's fine. If you need to add some title in it, you can add it. Policies, correct. And then this is the chart basically, and you can share this chart across with your boss or maybe your stakeholders, whoever it is, correct. And you want to visualize this particular data sets, you can show them across. And you can add the table as well, right guys? This will help you to understand what exactly data is presenting. So just click on the plus point and you will get the more on more fields. And you can change the color code as well, guys. You can see over here, so you know, I'm just hovering this particular thing, you can see change color changes in it, correct. And then quick element, you need to add some elements in it with the appropriate accesses, you will get it done. Cool, so this is the thing. And yes, we are available on every social media platform, guys. If you need any support or help on the Excel, you feel free